A Pike County man is shot and killed. Dogs were killed during a Johnson County burglary, and a white nationalist group plans a rally in the city of Pikeville. It all happened this week. Welcome, everyone, to This Week. For the next half hour, we'll catch you up on news you may have missed and give you updates on the week that was in your hometown. The week had barely begun as tragedy hit the headlines Monday as we brought you the story of a Pike County family who were seeking answers after a loved one was found shot to death inside his home Saturday. EKB News reporter Chris Anderson brought us the story.
54-year-old Clancy Adkins was shot and killed in broad daylight while inside of his home Saturday evening. Now police and Adkins' family are looking for answers.
I just don't understand. I don't know. No.
Pike County Coroner Russell Roberts said the shot that killed Adkins was fired through the glass of a storm door on Adkins' home on Coon Branch off Right Fork of Island Creek Road near Pikeville. Roberts said foul play was evident.
The storm door had been broken and shattered, and Then after that, a detective came in and we started doing further investigation. And after the investigation and everything, we determined that possible a homicide. It was the entrance door that he was at, as if he had opened the door for something or someone and had been shot through the door.
Clancy Adkins had undergone treatment for leukemia over the past couple of years. His family wants to know why his life was taken in such a violent manner.
Well, my uncle that lives at the foot of the hill heard two gunshots. He told me they were like 30 seconds apart. He heard the first one and he thought he heard my door open. And then he heard another one like 30 seconds later and he heard somebody holler out, "Oh God." And he said he looked up there and didn't see any vehicles in the driveway nowhere. So I don't know. He didn't see anybody. I'm just hoping whoever did this is caught. I hope they find out who did it, and I hope they're caught.
No arrests have been made, and the investigation is ongoing. Reporting in Pikeville for EKB News, I'm Chris Anderson.
By the end of the week, police still had no suspects and no motive in that case. A Johnson County woman was left with a broken heart and questions after her home was burglarized and her dogs were shot. Teresa Davis of Flat Gap says she doesn't understand why anyone would want to hurt her dogs.
And I have lived in that area pretty much all my life. And, you know, I don't know why someone would, you know, come into my house and take my dogs and shoot my dogs. I mean, it was just, it's unbelievable. I mean, I don't know who this person was. I have no clue who could have done this. But I do know one thing. I have a dog still at the vet's office fighting for its life. I have one that's deceased. I have one missing. I have two at home. Thank God that are okay. My dogs can't speak for themselves. I can. And they're going to pay for what they did for my dogs because my dogs was innocent in this. My dogs did nothing.
An unrelated incident a few hours later led authorities to a suspect in that animal cruelty case.
A little while later, we get another call in the Flat Gap area, completely unrelated. Deputy Martin responds over with Deputy Fairchild to that scene. It was an accident. During the course of that investigation, some evidence is found that may be related to the cruelty to animal complaint. That evidence was collected. All the evidence along with from both scenes will be sent to the Kentucky State Police Lab in Frankfort and Ashland for comparison. If this items match, then we will present the case to either the county attorney or the Commonwealth attorney, whichever cruelty statute it falls under, and charges will be filed accordingly.
Kentucky has some of the weakest cruelty animal penalties in the entire nation. Shooting and killing another person's dog would qualify as a Class A misdemeanor, punishable by only up to a year in jail and a $5,000 fine. The announcement of a white nationalist group planning to hold a rally in the city of Pikeville in the coming months ignited a social media frenzy Wednesday. The Traditionalist Worker Party is planning to hold the rally April 29th and are asking those who attend to wear all black and to be prepared for a potential pushback. According to the Southern Poverty Law Center, the group has strong ties to neo-Nazi groups and advocates for racially pure nations and communities and blames Jews for many of the world's problems. Shortly after the announcement and opposition event, the Rally for Equality and American Values was scheduled for the same day. Organizers for that rally say they hope to counter the message of the alleged white nationalists.
So I'm the former president of the Pike County Young Democrats. And Ariana and I saw this coming around on Facebook. You know, once we checked out and saw that it was legitimate, we decided that something needed to be done in a bipartisan manner to show that Republicans and Democrats, nobody thinks it's okay for Nazis to come into our town and hold a rally. It's something that we're all completely opposed to.
We're trying to get people of Christian faith there. All faiths are welcome. We're getting Republicans, Democrats, people who don't affiliate, anyone we can to show up. It's an anti-hate rally, basically. It's a rally for love, equality. Anybody that wants to come, veterans are especially welcome. I mean, this is something that we should have gotten over after World War II. And they say history often repeats itself, but I say not today.
The announcement of the Traditionalist Worker Party rally in Pikeville also sparked social media comments from the University of Pikeville chaplain, Rob Music. The chaplain invited the group to take part in a friendly debate-type forum discussing the group's beliefs. Music told EKB News the group has accepted his invitation and planning is now underway.
And I thought, well, here are people that have a concern. I may fundamentally disagree, but I want to respect them, invite them to the table. So that was, you know, let's not do any capital letters, no exclamation points. This is respectful dialogue. What I did was I put it on their wall, and then I sent them a private message. They emailed me right away and was like, man, we really appreciate the offer. This would be great. We'd love to have this conversation. And so we're going to do it. We've invited them to do an evening so we could do a public time. We're going to host it hopefully at a church. We're looking for a church to host us and to have a public conversation.
Pikeville City Manager Donovan Blackburn issued a statement to EKB News confirming the Traditionalist Worker Party had requested a permit to assemble in the city. Blackburn said the city, in recognition of the First Amendment rights of the group, issued the permit. He added that communication is ongoing with the group to ensure all assemblies held in the city are done properly. He also said, quote, Pikeville is a peaceful, respectful, and a diverse community that fully supports the Constitution and the rights of all citizens. A portion of the city of Pikeville was without power for a few hours Monday night, not because of a storm, but a two-vehicle accident that occurred on Bypass Road in front of Pikeville Medical Center that sent one vehicle crashing into a power pole. Three people were transported to PMC to be treated for non-life-threatening injuries. Bypass Road, however, remained closed to all through traffic for several hours for cleanup and to allow Kentucky Power to restore power. Coming up, the retrial for a Floyd County man accused of a double murder has been delayed again. But first, EKB Chief Meteorologist Latham Hopkins will be in with a look back at the week in weather and tell us what to expect for the upcoming week. Stay with us on This Week.
Pikeville Medical Center's Emergency Department has immediate openings for NPs, RNs, ED technicians, EMTs, and paramedics. PMC is a Level 2 trauma center and is home to an $11.3 million state-of-the-art emergency department and the region's most advanced medical technology. PMC offers great pay and an excellent benefit package. Call 606-218-4908 or visit pikevillehospital.org to apply.
This is what it feels like when you have more month than money. And this is what it feels like when you let Speedy Cash help.
Hi, this is Linda Kynes at Speedy Cash. We know better than anyone that sometimes you just come up short on bills, supplies, or whatever the case may be. At Speedy Cash, we can help with specials for first-time customers, and all transactions are confidential, and all checks are held for 30 days. Call me today for a location near you.
If you need cash fast, it's Speedy Cash.
From where it happens, when it happens, EKB TV news reporters are on the scene with live local coverage powered by the 4G LTE network of Appalachian Wireless. You get our live on-location reports by way of the newest technology available. We've got you covered at EKB TV. From Johnson and Lawrence counties in Kentucky to Buchanan and Dickinson counties in Virginia, From Perry County, Kentucky to Mingo County, West Virginia. Whether the news is in Pikeville, Paintsville, Grundy, or Clintwood, we're there for you with live local reports powered by the 4G LTE network of Appalachian Wireless.
Welcome back into This Week on EKB-TV. I'm Chief Meteorologist Lathan Hopkins, and I thought we'd take a look back at this week's weather, and it has been a roller coaster ride this week. 68 degrees on Monday. We had a couple of showers across the region. Those showers increased, even a few thunderstorms on Tuesday. But look at that, record high temperature of 71 degrees. The rain showers continued into the day on Wednesday. That's when we picked up the most rain, nearly an inch of rain with temperature of 64 degrees. Overnight Wednesday night into Thursday, the rain went over to snow showers. And yes, we did pick up a trace of snow across the region. We went from 64 Wednesday to 36 on Thursday and back up to 54 degrees on Friday. Now let's talk about the snow, because we are running a snow deficit across the region. Normally by this time of the year, we should have well over 15 inches of snow so far this season. This year, we've only picked up about 4.5 inches of snow. And to compare it to last year, we had already had more than 23 inches of snow on the ground between, let's say, November, December, January, and February. Now, we do have a chance of some snow in the forecast, and that could happen as we get into Wednesday and Thursday of this upcoming week. It all depends on the track of this area of low pressure here. This one will be developing as we get into Tuesday night into Wednesday. At the same time, we should have some colder air trying to move in from the northwest. The track of this low will determine if we see some rain showers, rain and or snow, or all snow. Of course, if it's closer to our region, we would see more in the way of rain and snow. If it goes a little farther off to the south, may miss us totally. So this will be something that we have to watch again as we get into Wednesday and Thursday for the possibility of some accumulating snow across the region. Of course, we'll keep you posted right here on EKB-TV.
All right, thanks, Lathan. The retrial of a Floyd County man accused of a double murder has been delayed again. In 2012, 53-year-old Barry Hall was found guilty but mentally ill in the murders of his niece, Lisa Tackett, and her husband, Alan Tackett. The Tacketts were shot and killed outside their home in 2008 after a long-running feud. Once in prison, Hall filed an appeal in the case, challenging his convictions on the basis that gruesome crime scene photos of the victims were gratuitously used to sway the jury.
Well, it's, you know, it's a serious case. We're talking about a double murder here. It's not something you see very often. It's a case that we're determined to see through. We're going to retry it as many times as necessary, if it were to come to that, to make sure that a jury ultimately gets the final say in what happens to this man. The original trial resulted in a life sentence, and that is our goal at this point would be to obtain a conviction, and the same sentence that he's currently under is what we would be trying to get to.
Turner says that he expects the retrial will get underway later in the year. Coming up, a healthcare facility is helping their elders feel more at home with the help of the Big Blue. But first, Michaela Colley and Jamie Johnson will be in with sports on This Week.
Pikeville Medical Center celebrates February as American Heart Month. When it comes to treating heart disease, our Heart and Vascular Institute provides world-class care close to home. Your heart is in good hands with our experienced team of specialists. They treat a wide variety of heart conditions and perform difficult procedures using some of the most advanced cardiac equipment and technology available. To schedule an appointment, call 606-218-2201. Pikeville Medical Center. We're all heart.
93.1 WDHR, today's best country. Always the newest country from the biggest stars. Catch the Daybreak Morning Show weekday mornings from 6 to 9, where you can win cool prizes and even cold hard cash. 93.1 WDHR, today's best country.
Whisper. You want to feel connected, at one with your world. Informed, included, and inspired. So no matter where you are, when important things happen, we're here at all hours, in the moment, on every screen in your life. Your local TV and radio broadcasters. We investigate and inform, give back to the community, build the local economy, even save lives. America's number one source for news, weather, and information. And unlike any other news source, we're here, 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 and here. We are broadcasters, always here for you, wherever here may be. Text TV to 52886. Tell Washington local stations matter.
Transition to a life in a healthcare facility can be tough, but the staff at the Prestonsburg Signature Healthcare do all they can to make residents feel at home.
It's a Kentucky tradition to gather around the TV on game night and cheer on those Kentucky Wildcats. Prestonsburg Signature Healthcare is carrying on that tradition for their residents.
We started this a couple months ago when Kentucky plays at 7 o'clock. We come and do a pizza party with the elders. We let them have beer if they want. We have beer, pizza, chips, candy, whatever else we have fixed that day. And the elders love it. So every time Kentucky plays now, they want to know if we're going to have a party. Well, I think it improves their quality of life. I mean, this is what they did at home. You know, they love Kentucky.
You know what they say, once a Cats fan, always a Cats fan.
Favorite memories was when my granddaughter was a majorette there for 4 years. She was there when Tim Capps played ball. She went 4 years.
You've got a lot of stuff in your room, UK, right?
Everything in my room, UK.
So you're the biggest fan that there are, wouldn't you say?
Biggest fan they are.
Now, who's a better coach, John Calipari or Rick Pitino?
John Calipari.
You don't like Rick Pitino?
No.
For more information on Prestonsburg Signature Healthcare, simply visit them on the web at www.prestonsburghealthcare.com. Reporting from Prestonsburg for EKB News, I'm Sean Allen.
It was a busy week in high school sports, with basketball season heating up as we inch closer to postseason play. Are the Kentucky Wildcats back on track after a lackluster win over LSU? Who's going to stand out on the high school level in a couple weeks when district tournament begins?
And in case you missed it, Pike County has a new junior high champion in a game that was a throwback to the old days of basketball, with a loud capacity crowd cheering on the Hornets to victory. Let's look back at this week in sports.
We'll start with the 15th-ranked Kentucky Wildcats and their 92-85 win over LSU. Freshman Wenyin Gabriel enjoyed a career-high 23 points. Malik Monk was back to his old self, chipping in 23, while Darren Fox dished a game-high 6 assists. Kentucky squandered a 25-point lead, but held on for the win. Head coach John Calipari wasn't pleased.
If I could practice tonight, we would have gone 3 hours. I would have had them meet me at the gym at 10 o'clock, and I would have gone 3 hours until 1 in the morning, until people were puking. That's what I would have done. That's the old days. I can't do that. But we will practice 3 hours tomorrow. And I told him, if anybody says they can't go, you won't make the trip to Alabama. So don't go, or you'll go. And we're going to get after this and continue to build what you saw for three quarters of the game.
On the high school side, the Pikeville Lady Panthers avenged an early loss to Paintsville by taming the Lady Tigers 62-53. Grace Bartley scored 21 points for Pikeville as they handed Paintsville their first loss against a 15th region opponent. And on the boys' side, rivals Pikeville and Shelby Valley squared off for the final time in regular season play, with the Panthers taking care of business 56-41. The Panthers will have the top seed in the upcoming 59th district tournament.
On Thursday night, South Floyd pulled themselves together after dropping two of their last three games as the Raiders stopped McGoffin County 80-74. Jake Collins finished with 24 points and four steals in the win. Can't wait to see the Prestonsburg-South Floyd rematch coming up in the upcoming 58th district tournament.
And finally, it was championship night at Mullins as the host Tigers faced Phelps for the Pike County Junior High Championship. Hornets guard Dominique Francis scored 26 points and nailed 6 three-point buckets, giving Phelps the championship win 63-48. Congratulations to the Hornets.
The guys worked so hard. We put so much time in, effort, and to come here and beat Mullins at Mullins, I mean, it's unreal. I mean, they just give me everything they had, and I love every one of them. It's awesome.
Feels really awesome. I'm proud of my team, proud of my family, and I can't ask for no better.
The Fighting Marty Casey's. You got to love Phelps.
You got to love Phelps. And Marty, let me tell you, he was excited that Phelps won that championship.
That's a look at This Week in Sports.
Coming up, we'll introduce you to two inspirational people from our region, one who is hoping to make it on the big stage and one who recently appeared on the cover of a national magazine. Stay with us on This Week.
Pikeville Medical Center's Heart and Vascular Institute is a leader in heart care. Cardiovascular and thoracic surgeons Dr. Abdullah Atum and Dr. Dermot P. Halpin specialize in difficult heart and lung surgeries. They have performed more than 15,000 open heart procedures. Their office is located on the second floor of the PMC Clinic. For appointments, call 606-218-2202. Pikeville Medical Center, proud member of the Mayo Clinic Care Network.
When you think of radio and TV, you think of your favorite shows and stations. They're local, folks in your neighborhood. Yeah, that's right, they're right there with you, reporting on your weather, driving on your streets and roads, experiencing what your community experiences. Sure, they provide national and world news, but the real message, the real voice, is in your community, reporting on events that are relevant and important to you. This is especially important when your cable or satellite service goes down in a storm. You may not have cable. You might not even have cell service. But your local broadcasters will be there with up-to-date warnings and alerts. They are literally your lifeline to all that matters to you. And your local broadcaster is not just news. They bring you sports, your sports, the games as they happen. Your local broadcaster is there on the radio, on TV, bringing all the excitement directly to you. Your community, your life, is all brought to you by your local broadcasters. Up to date, informed, and important, just for you. We are broadcasters, your broadcasters.
There's a musical tradition here in the mountains unlike anywhere in America. During This Week, we shine a light on part of that musical tradition. So now sit back and enjoy our mountain music.
It's time now for Mountain Music, being brought to you by the Mountain Arts Center, the main stage of the Country Music Highway.
Welcome to another edition of Mountain Music. This week down at the Mountain Arts Center, we have the 2016 US 23 Country Music Highway Road to Fame winner, Tim Elkins.
She's got that hawk, y'all. Hey, y'all, that little swing when she walks. Country smile that drives a man wild.
Like most in this region, Tim's earliest memories of singing and playing music began in church.
It all started in church, you know, just like any other place, and any other singer. And I actually picked up the guitar when I was a young man, and my mom said I've been singing since I was a baby, so, you know, it all come natural, really.
Likes the crickets and the bugs and a coke and a bud on the riverside. Remember making love. Country Santa blood.
The last time Tim was on stage at the Mountain Arts Center, he was receiving a very special title.
It was when I won the Road to Fame competition. It was the last one he had. I'd done one cover song, and then I'd done a song that I wrote, and they called my name, so it was really surprising because, you know, there were some really good musicians and singers through that. So, you know, I wish we all could have won it, but, you know.
Hey, baby, I can love you all night long. She's a country girl, raised in the South. She likes a good time and loves to get loud. Ain't nobody.
When you live in the country, inspiration for a good country song is everywhere you look.
It's country in her blood, and it's just a song about a country girl, and you know, just I guess growing up in the country and what they're all about, I guess.
Country's in her blood. Country's in her blood.
When Pike County native Carol Mullins made a decision to exercise and eat better, her only intention was to live a healthier life. She never dreamed that it would lead her to the cover of a national magazine. EKB News reporter Shelby Steele has this week's Get to Know.
Get to Know is brought to you by Dr. Tiffany Todd Duncan, DMD, located on Mall Road in South Williamson.
Growing up in a small town, 39-year-old Carol Mullins never imagined receiving national recognition. However, last summer, Mullins managed to land on the cover of People magazine after losing over 130 pounds in roughly a year and a half.
It was really different because, you know, as a little girl growing up in Eastern Kentucky, you don't think that you're going to go to a place like the Hamptons or New York City and be on the cover of a national magazine. It's really mind-blowing, you know, when you think about it.
Mullins grew up in Pikeville, moved to North Carolina, and then to Lexington. After having two children and choosing the convenience of eating out more, Mullins noticed changes in her body and lifestyle.
I started my weight loss journey in September 2011, and I had to do it. I had high cholesterol, and I had type 2 diabetes and high blood pressure. It really got to the point where I really needed to get healthy. It was really starting to affect how I feel, and it started affecting everything in my life. It started affecting my kids, you know, how active I was with them. It started affecting my marriage, and it was affecting my self-esteem.
Mullins then started to eat right and exercise, and just a little over a year and a half later, lost over 100 pounds and was on the cover of a magazine.
I come from, you know, a small town, you know, being in the creeks and climbing the hills, and, you know, going from that to the Hamptons, it's really different.
Mullins hopes to be an inspiration to others. As the saying goes, if she can do it, I can do it. Reporting in Pikeville for EKB News, I'm Shelby Steele.
If you know someone who would be a good subject for Get to Know, send your suggestions to gettoknow@ekbtv.com. Coming up next, we'll fill you in on a few happenings in your area as we take a look at the week ahead. Stay with us. We'll be right back on This Week.
Pikeville Medical Center's Heart and Vascular Institute is a leader in heart care. Cardiovascular and thoracic surgeon Dr. Abdullah Atum specializes in difficult heart and lung surgeries. He has performed more than 10,000 open heart procedures. Dr. Atum is located on the second floor of the PMC Clinic with cardiovascular and thoracic surgeon Dr. Dermot P. Halpin. For appointments, call 606-218-2202. Pikeville Medical Center, proud member of the Mayo Clinic Care Network.
Tune in to Daybreak on 93.1 weekday mornings from 6 to 9 and Your Day on EKB TV weekdays at noon for an opportunity to win EKB's Eat Your Heart Out contest. 10 semifinalists are going to be chosen to attend Singled Out at the East Kentucky Expo Center on February 17th at 8 p.m. where they're going to compete for a grand prize that includes his and hers jewelry, dinner for two, a one-night stay at a local hotel, and a box of chocolate-covered strawberries. Eat your heart out, baby.
Looking for your true love? You might be able to find it at the East Kentucky Expo Center on Singled Out Pikeville, a game show that will pair you up with your dream guy or girl based off of MTV's Singled Out. The cost is only $10 per person and includes appetizers and drinks, but not alcoholic beverages. There will be a cash bar for that. The East Kentucky Expo Center will be hosting the Perfect Affair Bridal Show next Sunday, February 19th, where you'll be able to find everything you need for your big day, from catering, venues, wedding gowns, wedding rings, skin care, to weight loss plans, and so much more, featuring dozens of vendors from all around the region. Admission is only $5 per person. I hope you enjoyed our look back at some of the stories that made headlines this week. Be sure to tune in next weekend at 6 p.m. right here on EKB-TV. For this week, I'm Sean Allen. Have a great weekend.